The Amiga 1X 5000 is a successor to the Amiga 1X 1000, which is the next generation PowerPC Amiga computer motherboards. The original Amiga classic systems, which ran on the Motorola 68K series processors, were discontinued in the early 90s, and a few companies eventually tried to create a successor based on a PowerPC CPU to replace the older CPU. The first company who did that, iTech, was the first one to release a full motherboard for new PowerPC Amiga systems. But they made Amiga 1 motherboards, XEs, they were called, the model, and they called it quits after they developed those. And there were a few problems with the hardware. The current hardware is created by Aeon Technologies, and their hardware is better in that it didn't have the bugs, some of the bugs associated with the iTech hardware. So for me, from a hardware perspective, it's been a real pleasant experience using the X1000 and also this newer X5000. And where the lack of finish or lack of production is in the software. So the hardware works great. You can install Linux on your Amiga 1 motherboards, and those will run full-fledged without not many problems. There's not a lot of software and operating system development for the Amiga operating system, so it's slow, but it's great when somebody releases something for it. The X5000 is using... the E5500 PowerPC from Freescale. The model that I've got here is an X5000/020, which is a dual core CPU. There's planned an X5000/040 with a quad core CPU. The operating system only utilizes a single core right now. So the 2 GHz single processor is what's running everything. There's not a lot of optimization to use graphics cards, DMA, hardware DMA to improve speeds. So most of the processing relies only on the CPU. And when there are more drivers and support written for hardware DMA, hardware processing, including the video and the file transfers and so forth, then the speed will even improve some more. The cost is very expensive. A full system is around $1,900. The page that I've got up right now is for Amiga Kit. In the UK, they do sell direct to United States customers, and there's also a new distributor on the east coast of the United States called Amiga on the Lake. You can also get Amiga X5000 systems there. There is already in beta production is a smaller, lower powered motherboard that will run the operating system, and this system is supposed to be below $500 when it's released. It is in production and beta testing right now, and eventually it will be in commercial production, so you can buy one at the dealers.
Is that micro ATX or is that mini ATX?
Let's see what this board is. I can't remember if it's micro or if it's flex, but it is a pretty small board. If it's micro ITX. /170mm, whatever that is. I'm guessing it might even be smaller than micro ATX. It looks like a pretty small board. I think ITX is the one that's smaller than that. Does anyone know? Perhaps. Here's some videos that I've got posted on YouTube. The channel name on YouTube is HostCo, so you can watch all these videos online. I won't show them full length, but I'll give you a sampling here. There was an old Amiga software title called Wings that I loved and many people are familiar with. And it's been remade for Windows now, a newer version of it. And there's a programmer who's also porting some of the titles over to Amiga OS. One of them is the new Wings. It's not for sale yet because the programmer started working on other OS 4 tasks. So there's a lack of programmers and they all get overloaded with a bunch of stuff to do. So it's delayed, but you can obtain a demo, and the demo is quite functional. As you can see in this video, there's some gameplay right there. And you notice the more advanced 3D graphics that it's using. And it has the different game modes as the original does too. So there was the strafing run that was shown before this, and now you've got the aerial fight. This is a game called Urban Terror that you can download off of the internet for free. And there is a modified game house that will, or game, what do you call it, a wrapper, that will let you run this on Amiga OS 4. Here's a little demonstration of that. It's a first-person 3D shooter. So if you enjoy running around and playing senseless killing with bad guys, this is a good game. There's an integrated software package with the operating system now. That's an application store. It's called AMI Store. So this video goes over the instructions of how to download it if you are using an older version of the operating system. And I believe that it comes included with the newer ones. And you can browse titles in the App Store. You can purchase them on the Amiga. You don't have to use something externally. What it does is it launches a local web browser, and you can pay with PayPal or other forms of payment. And I'll show you a little bit more of this later. This is an emulator for Amiga Classic software titles. So what's being emulated right now is another game that I love. It's called Super Stardust, which was ahead of its time. It was a great game on the old Classic Amigas. This shows approximate speed and playability that it has under the new operating system. This is a sample of demos on that same emulator. So this is emulating the original Amiga, not just the CPU, but also the audio chips and the video chips and so forth. And what's demonstrating right now is that the emulator is actually running two instances at the same time. So that gives you an indication of the high processing power of the CPU. And also, this is an optimized version of the emulator that's being shown on the X1000, and the emulator is optimized specifically for the X1000. And Amiga audio visual demos were just fantastic back in the heyday in the 1980s and early 90s. And there's still many fantastic modern demos released as well for the old Classic Amigas. So with an emulator, you can enjoy all the old software titles. This is a little fun Tetris game with a twist. It's free, and you can see the board starts flying around as you try to play. It goes upside down. It's quite a challenge, and it's pretty fun. This is a multi-game system emulator called Final Burn Alpha, and this will let you play some older Nintendo systems, Sega Mega Drive, some arcade game ROMs and so forth. This is an example of I think this is a Sega game that it's emulated right now. And then R-Type arcade game. The famous arcade joust game. And who isn't tired of Sonic the Hedgehog? And there's some more advanced games too that I'm not familiar with. You can see that this is a newer, updated arcade game, but I don't even know the name of it. This is what I wanted to show in real time, which is web browsing. This is a YouTube being shown on the OWB web browser.
Jewish, the tyrants did it. Hitler took the guns. Stalin took the guns.
So it can play HTML5 videos at good speed using the browser. So that gives you a pretty quick rundown. See if there's anything else on here that would be interesting. I think that I'll just go ahead and show you the real system now. Oh, this is a pretty interesting sample of multiple videos playing at the same time. Again, this is just relying on the CPU. It's not graphics processor offloading this. So you've got plenty of CPU power for the application. Take a moment, Robert, if you want to cut and change something, I'm going to change the video input to the Amiga computer. Screen like rabbits, because this is an Easter theme. And in Candy, there's lots of different backdrops that you can choose from. This one has candles in the background, and the candles actually melt and get lower with time. I really like this one, fireworks. Amiga OS logo with little bubbles in the background. And here's two nice ones to end off with. Pleasant, peaceful ones with dandelion seeds floating around. And here's one with autumn leaves falling. I'll change it one to something that's less distracting, which is a simple Amiga checkered ball spinning in the center. Workbench Candy is included with one of the applications that you purchase through AmiStore. And here's the app. It's figuring out that it's offline right now, so it'll take a moment. So even without being connected, I can browse the items that are in the store here. They're cached. Has different games to choose from. Graphics utilities. Let's see what's on. General utilities here. And the Workbench Candy backdrops are part of the Enhancer package. There's three different levels of the Enhancer package that you can buy. They start at a low price and increase features and go up to a higher price. And I've been able to purchase everything pretty seamlessly. I haven't had any issues purchasing it and installing it on the computer. So it's a nice, easy feature to start having with the operating system that way, because a lot of companies and products are starting with, they're quite dependent on their integrated application store to distribute their products. The Enhancer Pack has a variety of utilities that installs on my computer. I haven't tested very many of them, but it comes with some enhanced video drivers for 3D and high resolution Radeon displays, enhanced calendar and clock. It comes with an additional docking utility. So the little docky in the lower left here is called X-Dock, compared to the AMI dock in the lower right hand. So I've been comparing those two and using them both. Amiga Amp will play all of your audios. This is a free download off of the internet, off of OS4 Depot. And I'm fond of old, horrible sounding 8-bit mods, so that's what I've got installed here. But it will also play CD quality music. And it has all of the features that an audio player would. It's got the shuffle feature. You can save your audio file lists and so forth. You can change left and right fade and equalizer frequencies. And then it's got some visual candy as well. Some audio scopes. Here's a pretty one called Subspace. There's an integrated file and utility called Filer. So if you don't like typing, and if the mouse is too slow for you to organize your files, you can use this utility, this Filer utility, which I think is invaluable to have. So I've got two windows up here. You can open as many windows of it as you want to. And what it does is allows you to go to your disk volumes, and you can copy and paste stuff in between them, or you can run files, for example. I'll come here on one of the volumes. I've got a video file here. So I can double click on the video file, and it will open itself up in the DV player. Recognize all different types of file types and open up the default player or viewer with the associated file type. Here's a demonstration of composite hardware rendering. It's a new Boeing demo, similar to the old Boeing demo of the original Amigas. What he included with this Boeing demo is the ability to change the camera view, so you can pan around this and move it around. And then he has a little hidden Easter egg on the back wall, which shows some of the original classic computer models. And I was able to download one game and install it to show you something. I had a little younger friend here earlier, 4-year-old, so I was trying to get a game for him. It took a while, he was patient, and I got one. This is a demo of Descent Free Space. I've showed you a crash. Yeah, don't try anything new while you're presenting. I'll reset this and you can see the startup row. I don't have it directly booting into the hard disk. What I've got is I've got a USB boot disk right now. And it's identifying the USB storage device to boot from. It's loading the Kickstart files from USB, and then what it's going to do after that is load the Workbench and operating system from hard drive, which is a lot faster than USB.
Why do you have it going through USB first?
I was in the beta program to test the motherboard and operating system, and I found a great gal last year that I started dating, and I haven't touched the computer in almost 5 months. So, I have competing Amigas right now, and so I haven't gotten up to speed on the latest boot code to boot from the hard drive. And then it's got the fully 3D rendered graphics here.
Just follow my lead, you'll be fine.
There is some. Certain video cards do have hardware 3D support, so you get great speed on some of the 3D games and utilities that support it. This is not a new game, but it's good to show off the 3D and the graphics capabilities of the operating system. So I'll watch my teammates try to find the enemy ships while I get them. There's also Free Space 2, which is supported. But there were a few things that I wanted to load that I didn't get around to loading. So that is the end of the demonstration, and thanks for checking it out.
Questions, anybody? Lars, the price that you paid for the board was $1,800 for the X5000?
I got it for a lower price than that because I just purchased the motherboard alone and then I assembled the components myself. But that's about the price, including the memory and the operating system and so forth, right now is about
$1,900.
And then the A1222 is supposed to retail for, I believe it's less than $500. And I expect, I mean, they're progressing on beta testing on that one a lot, so that one may be available before the end of the year.
Other questions? Okay, thanks, Lars.
Thank you.